Very good morning to all the children of class 9th D. Let's start. Yes, you can shift there. Let's start with our, I'll be continuing, but before that I want to check whether you have understood the chapter well or not. So I'll be asking questions first to check your knowledge. And then if I'm satisfied, then I'll continue. Okay. So first of all, yes, Prachi, tell me, from which book the extract of this chapter has been taken? Three men in a boat. Is she correct?
Yes.
Yes, this is the right answer. Fine. So now next question is, who is the narrator of the story? Nobody will speak the answer. Just raise your hand. Yes. Jerome K. Jerome is the narrator of the story and he's the protagonist also, one of the main characters. Fine. Yes, Riyanshika, you can keep on writing. That is correct answer. Fine. Then name two friends. Yes, Jia. Name two other friends except Jerome. Montmorency is a dog. That is two friends except Jerome. You forgot? Aapne hand raise nahi kiya. Yes, Divya. George and Harris. My next question is, who is considered the worst packer according to narrator, by narrator? Yes, Bhavansh. Harris is considered, yes, Riyanshika, correct answer. Harris is considered the worst packer by Jerome because how does he pack the things? He is very clumsy in packing, fine. Next is, who considers himself to be the best packer, best organizer in the world? Magan, answer it. Jerome himself considers. Okay. Yes, Arnav, please stand up. Nobody will speak. Fine. Just tell me that who wants to boss the job of packing? Nobody will speak, beta. Harris wants to boss the job. You can sit. Yes, Jadev. Who wants to boss the job? Harris wants to boss the job. Jatin, it means you are not attentive in the class. Jaydev and Arna both gave wrong answer. Very easy. Jerome wanted to boss the job. It is clearly mentioned in the chapter that I wanted to boss around. But yes, he wanted to be the superintendent, supervise, boss, equal, all things. Yes. Already he has been doing this in the past. So he says that if others sit idle and I do the packing, Jerome says that, it irritates me. Okay, so please dhyan se sunna baitho. See, this is very easy questions and these all were very easy questions. Now the problem is that you are not attentively listening. Not all the students. But I can say 50-60% students are very attentive. My idea of asking very simple questions was that whether you listen to me that day or not. Fine. So rather than, you know, and if I address a person, okay, you will answer, baki kya karte hai, let's talk now. No. You should even have interest, okay, but ma'am is asking that child. Questions are for everyone. You are in 9th D all together, not a single child to whom I'm addressing the question. Fine. After that poor result, you should be more particular ki I will listen to the teacher in a better way now. Coming to the schools and not listening to the teacher, I don't understand. So let's continue now. Be attentive. I will be asking questions in between. Now I am not going to write anything here. Yes, Pushti, tell me the name of the most important character according to you. Who is important according to you? Jerome, fine. Narrator of the story, Jerome K. Jerome or Jerome, you can say. Yes, now the second character, you tell me, who is the clumsiest one? Harris. Yes, the one who trots on butter. George. You should know each and every detail, MCQ, subjective, everything you should prepare yourself for. Then the naughty creature, yes. So you all are prepared now for the chapter. Montmorency dog. Clear? Yes, beta. You're talking. So all the characters are clear to all of you, and there is no any hidden theme in the chapter that we are going to dig into it. The simple lesson we learn out of this chapter is packing in itself is an art. It is a skill. One should not, without doing anything, one should not boss about, or one should not have a superiority complex. The way George used to say is, Harris, sit properly. Sit properly. Okay. So George was having superiority complex that I am the best packer in the world. And Harris is the worst, and George also doesn't know the art of packing. So unless and until we do ourselves, we will not learn. So one common lesson we learn out of this chapter is packing is an art. It is a skill. A particular way should be followed so that everything is intact, does not get destroyed on the way or during the voyage. Fine. So heavy objects to be kept at top or bottom? Bottom. Light objects to be kept at top. Fragile items or the things which can be easily broken should be. This is not mentioned in the chapter that to be kept in a box, but this is our understanding. Fine. We should carry such things in a very delicate way. So let's continue the chapter now. We have read so far that how Jerome starts the packing. Fine. He firstly thought that he will be supervising, but actually he has to do all the packing. First time now, who will tell me that how many times he packed and repacked and why? Only two hands. You should be sure about it. Galat ho jayega, so what? Yes, beta. Three times. Firstly, he opened the bag for boots. He forgot the boots. Who gave the reminder of boots? Harris. Then again, he repacked. Then second time he opened it, he lost his toothbrush. Where was the toothbrush found? In one of the boots. Again, he zipped the bag. Then he forgot his spectacles inside the bag. Then again, he reopened it and then packed. So, three times, fine, right, but. So now when George asks him, what about the socks? He says, I give a damn about the socks now. He's so irritated that he does not want to open and repack the bags. Last second, desk, we are continuously talking. I'm going to split the seats now. Is it compulsory? Dharia, please go from that side. Arna, please give him the seat. And immediately lesson is going on. Let him come back easily. Fine, in 5 minutes or so. Then page 86. Though we have read about Montmorency, but we will read again. Now the dog's entry is there. Honors have shown their poor skills of packing. Jerome was forgetting things. He has the habit of forgetting. That's why he's not a good packer. Harris and Josh both are very clumsy. They keep everything in a pile on the floor, and then they forget where is the thing. A particular thing is nowhere to be found. Then George trots on the butter. Harris squeezed the tomato by putting a strawberry jam jar over it. Fine. Then they started the packing of hampers by breaking a cup. Remember? So how clumsy they are. So hampers ki packing bhi bahut buri rahi hai unki. Now Montmorency's entry. Whenever they try to catch anything, any hamper, what they find? They find cold, dampened nose of Montmorency. Wo har jagah pe, jahan pe wo haath karte hai, he just enters his, pokes his nose into it. So that shows dog is also very naughty, and he's adding more into the chaos, more into the clumsiness of packing. Paragraph 12, page 86. Montmorency was in it all, of course. Montmorency's ambition in life is to get in the way and be sworn at. If he can squirm in anywhere where he particularly is not wanted and be a perfect nuisance and make people mad and have things thrown at his head then he feels his day has not been wasted. तो एक ऐसा dog है who loves to interrupt others, who loves to create naughtiness, who loves to, you know, gets hit by people. When people shout at him, gets irritated, throws things at him, then he feels satisfaction ki yes, I have done or achieved something. So dog is also like Harris and George. So what do you learn about the character of Montmorency? Who will tell me? Yes, Jatin, answer it. Honors and masters, yes. What else? He loves to disturb others, and then he feels satisfaction after disturbing others. Very good. Clear? So, to get somebody to stumble over him and curse him steadily for an hour. So, he wants that he should enter into the path of people when they are walking. People should fall, they should stumble, and then he feels happiness. The highest aim and the object, and when he has succeeded in accomplishing this, his conceit becomes quite unbearable. Means conceit is when we feel pride in ourselves. So he's so proud of himself when he disturbs others. This is the character sketch of Montmorency, the naughty dog. He came and sat down on things just when they were wanted to be packed. Whatever thing is required to be packed, he sat over it. He labored under the fixed belief that whenever Harris or George reached out their hand for anything, it was his cold, damp nose that they wanted. He put his leg into the jam and he worried the teaspoons and he pretended that lemons were rats. Means dogs, they run after cats and rats and they feel good. So he started playing with the lemons, just like the balls and just like they run after the rats. And then he put his leg into the jam. You can get a question. What did Montmorency do or what did he do to add into the cure? So these are the things. Fine. He pretended lemons are rats and got into the hamper and killed three of them before Harris could land him with the frying pan. So whatever was required, only dampened nose of Montmorency was found. Paragraph 14. When we are done with the chapter, I'm not going to give answer to a single question. You people will give me. Fine, because we have read the chapter thoroughly. Harris said, I encouraged him. I did not encourage him. A dog like that does not want any encouragement. Now, as you know, that blame game starts. Firstly, Jerome started packing. Fine. And then George and Harris were doing so. And when George and Harris were packing, dog was interfering a lot because dog is not interested in packing of clothes and boots. He was obviously interested in the packing of food items. Fine. So that's why he disturbed Harris and George more. So Harris blames Jerome, the narrator, that you are encouraging him. He says, I did not encourage. Such dogs do not need any encouragement. They are like that only. A dog like that does not want any encouragement. It's the natural original sin that is born in him that makes him do things like that. It means it is the natural instinct of the dog. What is the explanation given by Jerome? Jerome says, ye dog aise hi hai. This is in his habits. It is in part of his natural instinct that he's naughty by nature, so I'm not encouraging him. The packing was done, underlined, at 12:50. This is the night time. So AM is there, okay? 12:50 AM and Harry sat on the big hamper, said he hoped nothing would be found broken. Hamper ko pack karke upar baith raha hai aur wo keh raha hai ki nothing will be found broken. You can very well imagine. Hampers ke upar kaun baithta hai? Fine. So Harris is the most clumsiest one. George said that if anything was broken, it was broken, which reflection seemed to comfort him. He also said he was ready for bed. So George said, let's be ready for bed now. Let's sleep. We were all ready for bed. Harris was to sleep with us that night and we went upstairs. We tossed for beds and Harris had to sleep with me. He said, do you prefer the inside or the outside? J means Jerome. I said I generally prefer to sleep inside a bed. Harry said it was odd. George said, what time shall I wake you fellows? Harry said, 7. Now after getting their proper sides of the beds, whatever they wanted, now George asked them, at what time I shall wake you up? Harry is a lazy guy. He says 7. And narrator is early riser. He says 6. Because I wanted to write some letters. That was the reason Jerome wanted to rise up early. Harris and I had a bit of a row over it. Row over it means disagreement. Fine? So row over it means kind of disagreement. But at last split the difference and said 6:30. 6:30 means 6:30. So they decided ki neither 6 nor 7, let it be 6:30 a.m. in the morning. George made no answer, and we found on going over that he had been asleep for some time. So we placed the bath where he could tumble into it on getting out in the morning and went to bed ourselves. Fine. So George was fast asleep, and we yahan pe kaun hai? Jerome and Harris both. Where he could tumble into it on getting out in the morning and went to bed. So they arranged the bath tub and then they went to sleep. Fine. Further, I will not discuss what happened in the book because you will be confused. Agar main aapko sari story sunane baith jaun, what happened in 3 men in a boat, aapko lagega ki, okay, this is part of chapter packing. So you might give wrong answers also. So I will not continue. If anybody of you is interested, you can read on your own at your level, but do not intermix the things of chapter packing. Clear? So let's discuss in pairs online, children. Am I clear? Any doubt to all of you? So you can also answer now. Yes? You'll get to know. Bahut kuch hota hai baad mein. A lot of things, a lot of clauses are there. But in between, this part of the novel was interesting, which is in your, but some parts are there in 3 Men in a Boat, you don't feel like reading even. But some parts are very interesting also. On the whole journey will be described. But aage jaake kya hota hai ki all will be discussing past incidents only. Kyunki unko rasta kaatna hai boat mein. So what they do is they start discussing their own past stories to one another. So un stories mein kitne characters aayenge novel ke andar, a lot of characters, a lot of things. Only casual incidents, nothing special. No. It is travelogue. This is called when you travel places, travelogue it can be considered. Autobiography is when you write about yourself. He is writing about his friends also. It's one of the incident, but it is not autobiographical. Autobiographical things when you talk about yourself, your birth, your studies, your parents, how you achieved what you are. So many elements are there. This is not autobiography. Okay. So let's continue. Page 89. You can raise hands. Fine. How many characters are there in the narrative? Name them. Do not forget the dog. Very easy. Yes, please stand up. Your name is? Aapke piche. Gurshan. Now I'm recalling the names I have forgotten. Yes, Gurshan will answer this question. Nobody will speak. Yes. Yes. Firstly, you have to tell that in class 9, you're starting George. You say that, ma'am, there are 4 characters. See the question in the book. In a smart way, 9th class, I do not expect single word answers. Pratiksha, yes, I'll get back to you with the next question. Be ready with that. There are 4 characters. You are right in the narrative. Name them. Is it that difficult? Who can answer by adding up more elements into it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Raghav? Gagandeep, yes. Badjo, beta, badjo. Sit down. Anything else you want to add up? Yes? Lazy person, George. How George is lazy? We cannot give the trademark kind of trait to them, but yes, you can say that the chapter, yes, how many characters are there? There are four characters in the narrative in this chapter. First of all, we have the narrator of the story is Jerome, K. Jerome, who is the protagonist also, who believes that he's the best packer in the world. Fine, that you can add up. Then we have Harris. You can mention. But then we have Harris and George. Both are friends of Jerome, who are very clumsy. All together you can talk. Then we have another very naughty character, a dog named Montmorency, who loves to poke his nose into every thing. Fine. So this is the 30-40 words bola, so you can add up. Okay. Yes, Titiksha, you can give the answer to second question. Nobody will speak, beta. Aapki bhi turn aayegi. Let me give the chance to online children also. Yes, Titiksha, second question. Why did the narrator volunteer to do the packing? Yes. I gave you the option to unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, speak.
The narrator said that he knew more about packing than any person living in this world. Moreover, he would get an opportunity to watch it. He would get an opportunity to watch the job and George and Harris would do the job under his directions.
Yes. Okay. Fine. Good. Yes. Answer given by Titiksha is that narrator Jerome volunteered to do the packing. Though he wanted to supervise it, but he offered his help to both and they agreed to it. Divya answer. Yes, exact answer of second question. Once again, that side is not listening. Jaspal? Jaspreet paar jaana? Haan ji, boli. Pehle ab chup karoge to sunega is side ko. I'm going to split the seats. Tomorrow you won't sit like this. One boys row, ask your class teacher, fine. One boys row will be here and then girls and then boy. Let's see. Girls are maintaining the silence throughout. Yes, Divya, please speak loudly. I'm not able to concentrate this way. Last boy. Fine, you know. Mask doesn't mean that we are not able to perceive who's speaking, who's not. So sit down, please. Clear? The narrator volunteered to do the packing. Firstly, he believes that he's the best packer in the world. He knows the art of packing. And secondly, he thought he would offer his help only here and there to both the friends, Harris and George. But he ended up with doing all the packing as they did not do anything. They just sat and did not do anything. Clear? How did George and Harris react to this? Did Jerome like their reaction? Yes, Pushti? So reaction is George and Harris did not say anything to this. They agreed to what Jerome said. They accepted the offer and sat idle, did not do anything. Did Jerome like their reaction? They easily agreed to get the packing done by Jerome. And Jerome did not like this reaction at all. He gets so irritated. Yes. What was Jerome's real intention when he offered to pack? Very easy. Yes, dear. Yes, so Jerome's real intention was to boss the job. He did not want to do the actual packing. He just wanted to help Harris and George. he wanted all the works of packing should be done by his friends Harris and George only. What did Harris, question number 5, beta, what did Harris say after the bag was shut and strapped? Why do you think he waited till then to ask? Yes, Nabil.
Harris said, and he's going to put the boots in. Harris did this to irritate
him. Yes, so Harris said, after the bag was shut and strapped, Harris gave a reminder to the narrator that he forgot to put the boots in the bag. Why do you think he waited till then to ask? He waited till he strapped, till Jerome strapped the bag because he wanted to irritate him or wanted to, he wanted to make fun of him. He wanted to have fun also, fine. What horrible idea occurred to Jerome a little later? Yes, Naisa and both of you, Soumya. One question each, chaliye. Naisa, give answer. Lisa, I'll give you the chance after. Horrible idea. Very horrible, sir. Lisa, please speak loudly, okay? Baitho na, sir. Lisa, you can give answer loudly.
Jerome opened the bag as he was going to close it. A horrible idea came to him. It was if he had packed his toothbrush, he had problems always with his toothbrush.
Yes, very good. So students sitting at home are able to concentrate and you people are not. So yes, she has given right answer. The horrible idea occurred to Jerome a little later was about if he had packed his toothbrush inside or not. He always forgets his toothbrush while packing. And then after reopening the bag to put the boots inside and again when he repacked it, strapped it, he realized he forgot his toothbrush to pack inside. Clear? So that was the horrible idea. Next is, where did Jerome finally find the toothbrush? Yes. He find or he found? Yes. In one of the boots. Fine. Obviously, one brush cannot be present in both the boots. Okay. So he found the Jerome found the toothbrush in one of the boots. One of the boots hota hai. Make sure. If I say one of the boots, matlab do boots mein se ek. Clear? And next is, why did Jerome have to reopen the packed bag? Question number 8. Okay, beta, bell ho gayi.